Charlie Condou's right here with me now. We all got a bit of a shock, didn't we, on Holby last week? I think I spat my tea out when Ben kissed Dom. And there's another surprise in store tonight. Well, we weren't expecting that, Charlie Condou. Well, what's going on?
I don't know. It was a shock to me.
I mean, I know Dom is cute.
He's
cute
gorgeous.
As a bug's ear.
Gorgeous.
And who could resist?
Well, absolutely. And I think that was what Ben was saying. He got caught up in the moment.
I know. It's really interesting, though, isn't it? It's an interesting development because he's had a disastrous love life, hasn't he? I mean, it's just been terrible. You know, he has picked some bad
decisions. He needs a break.
He does. He does. And this could get very seriously awkward.
I think so, particularly because Essie's his best friend. So,
I know.
I mean, there's that as well. And now that he knows that Ben's about to propose, I think it makes it all the more awkward.
I know. What's he going to do? Is he going to tell her? Is he not? It's just this terrible thing. I think he should. Like, this is Matthew. I think he should tell, right? And then it all goes horribly wrong. And then Essie and Sasha can get together.
Yeah, this is what people seem to want.
This is what we want. This is what we want. But you and Holby, it's a perfect fit. It just works.
It works perfectly for me. I mean, I loved it. My time at Coronation Street was fantastic, and I loved the job, the people, all the rest of it. But being in Manchester was really difficult because my family are based down here, my kids are down here, and I just wasn't getting to see them. So that's why I left. Holby's perfect. I can drop the kids off at school and be at the studio in 15 minutes. I mean, it suits me down to the ground.
That just sounds
so good.
What about all the medical jargon, though? Because I always say, I'm so impressed by you guys when you go, whatever it is you say, because I've no idea what it is. I mean, is that quite difficult? Is it quite hard? I mean, I know it's
I think it's hard learning lines anyway, but I've got into the habit of being able to do it quite quickly. But the medical jargon, I mean, there's so much of it, and I haven't got a clue what I'm talking about. Luckily, they've got really good medical advisors on set.
So if you do a slip up, they can say.
Well, also when you're there and you're working through the scene and you're saying, "What does this mean? What is it? What's the operation?" They tell you everything. So while I'm doing the scene, I know exactly what I'm talking about. 5 minutes afterwards, it's gone.
Yeah, no I get idea. It. But you know a lot of the cast, don't you? That must be really lovely, because then you don't feel like the real newbie when you arrive.
Yeah, and that's always a weird thing when you start a new job anyway, although I'm quite long in the tooth now, so there's always somebody on set that I know. But David Ames, who plays Dom, is an old friend of mine, and we get on great. Kay Ragg, who plays Essie, I've known as well. So there are people that have been on the show, Dawn as well, who's gone into the show now. Who's she playing? Ange.
Oh, yeah, I like that character a lot.
For years and years,
yeah, she's brilliant. Very, very good.
Really great actress, Dawn Steele. So it was lovely. It was like coming home.
No, exactly. Do you know what I really admired about you? When you left Cody, and you know what it's like when you're an actor, you know, jobs, you get a job, but sometimes you're resting, as they say, but you didn't rest, you worked. I think that's admirable.
Listen, I came out of Corey and I did very well. Thank you very much. I mean, it was lovely and I had some great work and great jobs. And then I had some periods where I didn't, like all actors do. And my friend Andy Oliver, who's one of the judges on the Great British Menu now, she had a restaurant. She said, come work with me in the restaurant. So I did. Not for long, for a couple of weeks and whatever. But
why wouldn't
I've got kids, I've got a mortgage, you know.
But I don't understand why people would have a go at that. As I said,
it's snobbery. I think it's admirable. It's silly. And I think people seem to think that being an actor is somehow better than being a waiter, which is ridiculous. I mean, it's definitely, you know, you get paid more and you work less. but, you know.
I know. Being a waiter, sometimes you have to be a blinking good actor
as well.
You really do. You really, really do. How's the family?
They're good. They're good. They're really well. Cameron sends his love to you today.
Oh, look.
The kids are at school.
Gorgeous.
Oh, look at them there.
God, they're really growing up, Charlie.
They're really growing up. It's terrifying. I mean, you know what it's like.
But do you still get asked advice? Because I know that you did, you know, you wrote about your family and the alternative parenting week that you did, which I think is fantastic.
Yeah.
And families come in all shapes and sizes now. But do you sometimes get people just asking you...
I do.
Advice, really.
Lots of advice, lots of how did you do it, how did you make it work? And I'm fine with that, actually. I think one of the reasons that I wrote my column in The Guardian and one of the reasons that I've talked about it so much, I feel like I'm always banging on about my family, is that there wasn't anybody, there were no gay people having kids when I was growing up and I didn't have anyone that I knew of. I mean, obviously, we've got Elton and David and Ricky Martin and all those people that copied me.
they did.
So, yeah, I was the first. I wasn't the first at all. But it was nice that I was out there publicly talking about it. And the conversation has changed now. You know, younger generation of gay men and women and the trans community as well, and everybody are suddenly making their own families. And I think that's a fantastic thing. If you want to be a parent, you should be a parent. Your sexuality really shouldn't get in the way.
No, it should not. It really should not. As long as, I mean, look, your kids are, like, so happy.
They're pretty good. We're lucky. We got a couple of good ones. No, they are. That's their mum as well.
Oh, it's great. See, I love the way that you've just worked it out. You just worked it out. No, I think that's brilliant. Are you going to be staying in Holby for a while? Please say you are.
No, I'm not. It was just a stint.
Oh,
it was
no.
just a little stint. But, you know, I've had conversations with them. You know what it's like in a show like that.
Yeah.
The door was very much left open.
And, I hope so,
and,
Charlie.
You never know.
I really hope
Watch this space.
Because I'd like to see more of them. Like I say, I don't want him to be with Essie. He can be with someone else if he wants.
Well, he doesn't seem to be fussy, so, I mean, he can be with anyone.
Zen for Charlie.
That's right.
Zen for Charlie.
He'll get off
with
anyone.
It's so good to see you.
It's good to see you, too.
It really, really is. And, obviously, Holby's on tonight. It's actually on tomorrow as well.
It's on twice this week.
It is.
Tonight, tomorrow, because of the football, I think.
Exactly. Double dose. Excellent. That's what we like. Thank you, Charlie.
You're very welcome.
Great to see you.